Hello friends, today I am going to show you our new voice broadcaster. I would like to show you this. This is our machine, GSM broadcaster, and with 32 ports in it, 32 receivers. You can see there are 32 SIM cards inserted in it. As you can see, I would like to focus on it. You can see these 32 SIM cards inserted in it, plus these 32 receivers on it, plus these are the indicators, power, run, LAN, PC and error. All you guys understand, power is for power, run is if the software is running properly. If it is connected to the LAN, then it is LAN. If it is connected to the PC, if there is any error, you'll find a red blink here. Right, so I'll show you how it works, but first I want to show you the machine, the setup. Actually, these are the phones which we will use to show you the voice broadcast. I would like to show you the rear portion of the machine. Here is the power pin, and here is the LAN connection, and it is connected to our laptop. You can see, plus we have our software also, which my friend will start. I'll show you. It is connected with our own developed software. We have developed the software. We will demonstrate it to you guys. So friends, now I will demonstrate you our interface, our software interface, which is this GSM broadcaster. I'll show you how it works exactly. I have already shown you the machine. I have already shown you the setup. See, this is a import tab here. I'll show you something else first. I have a test number notepad file already there, which I will show you. Let's see, test numbers. These are the test numbers, four test numbers, which I have already there in this notepad file, which we will import, right? And we have one more. I'll show you. We have one pre-recorded WAV file also. That is here. It is our pre-recorded. Let me repeat. It is our pre-recorded. This is our pre-recorded WAV file, which we will import in it. So let's go. Friends, we will import our contact file from here first, right? That is test numbers. These are the four test numbers. This is the test numbers notepad file, which we will import. It is imported here. You can see all the four numbers here. Now we will browse for the audio file. Here is the audio file. We will select this also. This is also imported. Now let's start the broadcast. I'll show you live how it records in the mobile phones, how it comes to the mobile phones. Now you guys can see, if we, here is the DTMF detail. I mean, if the person is pressing 1 in his mobile phone, it is coming 1. He has pressed 2, and this guy has pressed 5. So from this we can come to know whether the customer is interested in the service or not, because we do this voice broadcast. Okay, it's too much of disturbance here. Now I'll disconnect all the calls. Please disconnect. So you have already checked everything, how we have done. DTMF entry has also come. If the guy has pressed 1, it has come 1, it is 2. Now we will save the reports. I'll show you how the report comes.
We have saved the reports. Report, we'll make a file, we'll save it on desktop. Save it. And now I'll show you how the report comes. This is the format of the report. This is the number. This is the, we can also, I mean, get it in Excel format. We can convert it into Excel format also. This is the number. This is the status completed. This is the time at what time it, the call was made. This is the time and this is the duration of, the duration is in the last. It is 42 seconds, 47 seconds, 54 seconds, right? And this is the timing and this is the entry, what he has pressed, 1, 2 and 5. This is the DTMF entry. It shows whether the customer is interested, not interested, whatever he has pressed in his, on the keypad, and it comes to us real time. So that is all, my dear friends. That is all I wanted to show you for the, okay, one more thing I want to show. Here is a retry button. We can write it here 2, 3, 4, 5, anything. I mean, how number of retries we want, we can, maximum calls we can make up to 25. 25 we keep because there are 32 ports. We can take it 32 also, but sometimes what happens is if the port is busy, it creates problem. So we keep it 25 in our machine. If we have number of machines, we can make it 30, 40, 50, 100, 200, whatever we number of machines and ports are available with us. So that is what I wanted to explain you guys. Thank you so much, and for your inquiries, you can mail me rg@bowl7.com or info@bowl7.com. I'll mention that in the description also. Thank you so much.